3 a.m. with a new video, and I know I've already started my makeup because I didn't plan to film this. And then I was like, maybe there is things I want to talk about, but I don't know. But I'm going to do whatever I'm doing right now. I am using the Club Nebula palette from Kaleidos and Angelica Nyquist, because I'm planning on doing or filming my best palettes of 2021, and this is the best palette, I think. I just started with this one, and I think I'm just going to do my makeup and not describe to you what I'm doing. So I like don't even know what I want to talk about. I just felt like maybe I want to film, so I did just start the camera, and here we are, and now I have no idea, and I don't know. I maybe should take this shadow. What did I even want to talk about? And the lighting? I don't know. How can I be so bad with the lighting all the time? I don't know. One part of me like want to talk a little bit about what's happening next year, and one part of me have no idea what's happening next year. But I think there will be not that many videos, because at my work, okay, this wasn't a good choice to take this shadow. Why did I do that? I going to have a new things to do at work for a couple of weeks, not a couple of weeks, for 10 weeks, and I will be more stressed. I will change my working hours, and I will be more stressed because I'm doing new things. So I have no idea how much I'm going to be able to film and how much I want to film. I have no idea. But I'm really trying to just do whatever I feel like when it comes to my channel. If I want to film one day, I'm just going to do it. If I don't want to do it, I'm just not, because this is my hobby and you know that. So don't like expect anything from me next year. I hope that I really can find a good routine with filming and really like just sit down and do it, because when I am filming, I often think it's very fun, but it's just like the way to film that is a little bit hard to me, just to sit down. And I'm always worried about that it's going to be too late to film. And like now, I don't know if I'm going to be able to film my favorite palettes of this year. I don't know. But I think I just have to let go of trying to have control over it. And if I make it, I make it. Okay, but that's all I wanted to say. Is that why I started my camera? I have no idea. When I'm filming this, it's the 28th of December. And it feels so strange that this year is almost over. And it's going to be 2022. It even like feels strange to say that. I don't know why, but it does. And one part of me is so happy that this year is finally going to be over. And I just hope that next year will be better. I have actually been thinking of trying to do, is it called meditation? Is it called meditation in English? My boyfriend does that every day, and he do really like it, and he says that I might going to like it, and that will help with my anxiety and for me feeling so stressed. Yeah, I guess he's right. I guess it would be good for me, but I don't know. The thing with me, I've talked about this so many times before, if I'm not good at anything the first time I try it, I don't want to learn. And like, you have to do meditation more than once. I love it if it's not meditation in English. You have to do it more than once to be good at it. Do you have get something out of it? I get that. And do I really want to do it then? But maybe that is something that I should work on myself with next year. I know. And maybe I should just give it a try and see. Maybe it's something that really makes me feel better. I don't know. Okay. Do I know what I'm doing right now? I actually don't know. I had an idea at first what I wanted to do for a kind of a look. But I don't know if it was this that I did think of. But I guess that I'm not super mad with this look. Yeah, I could talk about Christmas maybe. And if you don't celebrate Christmas, maybe you don't want to hear about it, but we did. I was just so happy that I wasn't sick this year at Christmas, because if you didn't know this, I did have the thing that we don't talk about last year. So my Christmas wasn't the best, and my boyfriend's Christmas, I think he might had a worse Christmas than me last year, because he couldn't do anything either. We were isolated and he had to take care of me. And I do not think I was a fun company last year. But this year we were both healthy, and we did celebrate here at home and ate some food, and I did actually do a whole vegan menu, whole vegan food, and did like spare ribs with tofu. Wasn't my favorite though. And then I did some, I don't even know what it's called. In Sweden, it is sill. And I don't know, I think we maybe are the only people that eats sill. But I did pickle like mushrooms and then made a sauce with like chili and things. It was a little bit too spicy. Yes, I had my first whole vegan Christmas, and I have actually decided to go 100% vegan from next year. And this year I've been eating a lot of vegan food. All the things I've cooked for myself has been vegan. I haven't eaten vegan when we have been out to dinner, and when I have been away at places like at my mom's or at friends, then I haven't been eating vegan food. But I think next year that I will try to be 100% vegan. I don't think it's going to be that hard because I mostly eat vegan now, and as long as I'm eating at home, there's no problem. The only thing. Okay. I have been eating vegetarian food for 20 plus years. Or, okay. For 20 years, I haven't eaten chicken or meat. Like cows, pigs, and stuff like that. And for the last 5 years, 6 years, maybe, I haven't eaten fish. Now, this year, I've been eating mostly vegan, and just let me tell you, when people ask me, was it hard to quit meat? No, not at all. I did quit because I did feel sorry about the animals, and I didn't want to eat meat. That's why I stopped. But I still ate fish and eggs and drank milk. And then I stopped eating fish and seafood. I think it was 5 or 6 years ago. And that was hard. It was more hard to quit fish than. I'm always like so. What even is this? Like I'm having stuff from my shirt or my pants all over. It was so much harder to stop eating seafood and stuff like that than it was to stop eating meat. But I did it. Like eating tuna. I loved eating tuna. Why is it always getting all like crazy when I put things on my face? The white balance? I don't know. And now I need to stop eating fish. It was really hard. But nothing to be compared with stop eating cheese. That has been the hardest. The absolute hardest thing for me is to stop eating cheese. Because vegan cheese has nothing on a real cheese. It does not. Cheese is amazing. And stop eating cheese like feta cheese and mozzarella and they just take cheese on a sandwich. Vegan cheese is not that good. That has been the absolute hardest to find a substitute for cheese. And I do have a problem that I don't know if everybody that's going vegan is. In Sweden, the normal like vegan cheese is made out of coconut oil. And I guess it tastes a little bit of coconut. And I guess if you like coconut, that is not a problem. But I do not like coconut. I actually hate coconut. And when you don't like coconut, and the cheese is made of coconut oil, it tastes a lot of coconut. So that has been really, really hard. There is some cheeses made out of like cashew, like cream cheeses, and they are so much better, but they are much more expensive because cashew is more expensive than coconut. And also I live in kind of small city. If like by Swedish measurements, it is I guess a normal city. In like US measurements, it's a tiny city. It's about 100k in like the big, whatever. In like the center of the city is about 60k. Why do I even talk about it? Yeah, so like there is not that many vegan options. It's mostly like the normal options. But yeah, quitting cheese has been the absolute hardest for me. And I'm starting to tell people that when they are like, oh, wasn't it hard to not eating meat? I'm like, no, but stop eating cheese. That has been the absolute hardest. I think as well, chocolate, like milk chocolate. In Sweden, we have the best milk chocolate ever. And you can't eat it if you're eating vegan food because it's milk in it. Most of like dark chocolates are vegan, but dark chocolate is not the same. But also this might sound a little bit strange, but I hope that if you are eating vegan or vegetarian that you are going to get what I mean. If you just stop eating something, you are forgetting how it tastes. And that is what I'm trying to do with cheese. I'm like, if I'm not eating cheese for a couple of months, I am going to forget how it tastes, and then I'm not going to miss it. And the same with like chocolate. If I don't eat normal chocolate or like milk chocolate, I'm going to forget how it tastes, and then I'm not going to miss it. And I don't know if that is like a tip if you want to become vegan to just try to forget about it. I don't know. But this has worked for me with a couple of things, and I'm just hoping that it will work for cheese as well, because I do miss cheese. And one thing that I missed in the beginning, it was eggs. Like, I do love like a hard-boiled egg. Or like scrambled eggs. But there is actually one thing that I have heard of it, but I haven't tasted it before. I bought it, I think it was maybe in the spring of this year. I'm going to Google this actually. It is in Swedish, it's black salt. I don't know if it is kala namak, and it tastes like eggs. It really do. It's like amazing. My boyfriend, he hates eggs, like the smell of it, and he can't be in the kitchen when I use that black salt because he can't stand the smell of it. And now I have. So that is a tip from me to you if you are trying to eat vegan and miss eggs. It's amazing. I like can't even grip how it works, but it does. And you know, this did turn out to something that I didn't thought it was going to turn out to. I'm going to try next year to do even more vegan food at home from scratch. Yesterday I did mix my own falafel mix, so I'm going to do falafel this week. I have done it once before. I often buy like frozen falafel, but I'm going to try to make my own for the second time in my life, and I just hope it will be good. And I think that Instagram is so good when it comes to trying to or to find vegan recipes. I have tested out a lot, and there is still cookbooks, a lot of vegan food. So yeah, I hope that like from 2022 I'm going to be 100% vegan. I really, really hope, and I'm really going to try. But at the same time, if I'm not succeeding, I am not going to be hard on myself. I'm just going to try to do my best. I don't know, oh, did this turn out to get ready with me? Get ready to be vegan? I don't even know if you think that this is interesting. And I just want to maybe put in a little bit disclaimer. If you eat meat, I frankly don't care. I have never tried to make anybody else to eat, to stop eating meat, because I don't think it's my place. And because I've been eating not meat for so long, it has been many times that people try to start a discussion with me about eat or not eat meat, and I hate it. I have never, never, ever in my life start a discussion about not eating meat. Never. But people have tried to start it with me. But I do not care what you eat as long as you feel good about it. I'm like, if I do not, I do not care what you eat, so don't care about what I eat. If people ask me, I do answer, but I do not want to talk about it. I never say that I am a vegan if it doesn't come to like somebody's going to make food for me, or we're going out to eat or anything, then I say it. But if not, I'm not going to. Drag it up because it's not my personality, or I do not identify as a vegan or a vegetarian. I have never done that. It's just I have chosen not to eat meat, but that doesn't define who I am. And if you that are watching me is eating vegan, please like give me tips on things that are really good that is vegan. I do like most things except for coconut then. But other than that, I like a lot of things. I am not a picky eater, and I haven't been for a long, long time. And I think it has something to do with I think that I might be a little bit of problem not eating meat, so I've been like, okay, then I'm going to eat everything that is not meat. I am even like that if somebody gives me food, I think I've talked about this, if somebody gives me food that I don't like, I'm not going to say anything, I'm just going to eat it. And I have heard from my friends that they don't like to make food for me because they never know if I like it or not because I always eat it up. But maybe that is just how I am raised. Did my mother do a really good job, maybe? I don't know. I think my brother is the same. Like, if somebody gives him something that he don't like, he's always try to eat it up. Okay, do you know what? I think I will finish this look off cam, because it feels like this is going out of control and I'm going to talk about, I don't know. But I will finish this look up. I'm going to do my under-eyes with the same shadows, I guess. Something in my waterline, setting spray, and a lippy mascara. And then I come back. So this is the finished look, and I think I will have red lipstick on my teeth. I took a lip toning from Kaleidos. This is in Ambition. And this is a kind of a bright red, but I do actually like it, and this is the look. I do like it as well. So I did use these three colors down here and also this one. And I do really love this palette, and it's so fun to play with it. And I hope that you liked this video that turned out to be apparently a vegan video. I don't know. But I hope you liked this video, and if you're not subscribing to my channel, please do so you don't miss any of my videos. And I hope I'll see you in the next one. Bye!